free spooling, click her on. There's one on this one. There's one on this one, guys. There's one on this.
I'm on.
What I'm about to demonstrate for you now is how I like to rig live bait for marlin. Now, there's a couple of different scenarios in which I'll use live baits for marlin. One, if I'm slow trolling a live bait on the surface, and another time where I might be pitching out a live bait. If I'm pitching out a bait, let's say a mackerel, if I'm pitching that out to a marlin that I've raised on a teaser, now of course I like to use a circle hook, so let's have a look at how we're going to attach that circle hook to that mackerel for what I've found gives me the optimum hookup rate, particularly when we're throwing out a live bait. Now that bait there of course is very dead, but we're just for demonstration purposes, let's imagine it's alive. Now, before I even get my bait out of the tank, I connect a rubber band. This is a number 32 rubber band. I just loop-de-loop connect that rubber band onto the circle hook. Now, that there is how I keep my live bait leaders ready to go with the rubber band already on them. It's now simply a matter of connecting my live bait hook to the rubber band. We're imagining this guy's live. There you go. Live. Look at that. He's live. Now, we hold him upside down in a wet cloth or towel. And at the very front of the eye cavity, we just poke our bait needle through. Now we're careful to stay at the front of the eye cavity where it doesn't puncture the eye, and we're just pulling that rubber band right through. At this stage, I ditch the live bait needle and I'm just pulling the end, the loop end, back over the hook. So there you go. At this stage, you can see there that I've just got the rubber band through the eyes and looped around. Now at this stage, I twist, and I twist till it's tight. Now if I'm going to be pitching the bait, not trolling the bait, my first time I come through, I like to come through from the front and out the back. Now I twist a few more times. This time I'm going to come from the top and down. And that's because I want the circle hook facing down like that. Now there's a reason for that. When you pitch out a bait, often the marlin are coming in very aggressive and they'll quite often whack them before they eat them. And I find if the marlin comes and has a whack at it with the hook facing up, that hook can get stuck on the bill. So I like to have the hook facing down, so if the marlin takes a swat, it's not going to get tangled. So the marlin will just come in, grab that. Now the rubber band holds it hard against the head. It can go completely inside. As you increase the drag, the beauty of the rubber band, even though that's hard against the head and it's less likely to tangle, it will still stretch away from the bait enough to get a clean roll into the corner of the mouth. And that there is how I would rig a live bait if I was pitching it out to a marlin. Now, if I was going to be trolling that and I wanted to use the rubber band rig, I'd simply come through so the hook's sitting up the other way. Now, that's because I found when I've been trolling, you don't seem to get the swat like you do when a marlin's excited on a teaser. And again, the marlin will eat that. That hook should pull free and roll into the corner of the mouth. However, when even with this rubber band rig, there is a possibility that the hook can turn back into the head. So for my next rig, I'm going to show you how I'm going to rig up this bait so the hook can't roll back in, and how I've had an excellent hookup rate. It's a pretty nifty rig, but before we get onto that, you can watch this rubber band rig in our unique watch and tie view. So you can see exactly what the left hand and right hand are doing. You can watch that step by step. But right now, I'm going to de-rig this guy and I'm going to rig up a live bait as though I was going to be trolling it. So now we're going to take a look at another way that I like to rig up live baits, and this one I've found I've had a phenomenal hookup rate. So no rubber band on there, that's just a snelled on circle hook. You can check out how I snell these circle hooks on, we've got a video of that, snelling circle hooks on ultimatefishing.tv. But that's my leader all ready to go. Of course, it's worth remembering that this can be scaled up and down for any kind of billfish. You're obviously going to be doing different size hooks and leaders, but it will still work everything from sailfish through to giant black marlin, this rig. So I've just taken a bit of nylon cord here, good strong whipping cord that I like to use for rigging my live baits. I've just doubled that over and I'm going to do it just an overhand knot. So I'm just twisting that around and I'm forming a loop. So that gives me a nice strong loop. I'll trim these tag ends off just to make it nice and neat. And just like the rubber band, I'm just going to loop that onto the leader. Okay, so far that's pretty standard. That's how most live bait leaders would be prepared and ready to go. However, with this rig, I like to add just a wee bit of copper. I've got a wee bit of copper wire here. It's about, I don't know, 3 inches long or 75 mil, depending on whether you're metric or imperial. I just have that twisted quite tightly. You can use some pliers onto the hook. Now, once I've twisted this bit of wire on here, I have them sitting ready to go just like that, ready to rig up for a live bait. Now, if we take our bait that we're demonstrating with here, again, if we were rigging this and it was alive, I would have it in a wet rag, holding it upside down. Rig, we just poke the bait needle through at the front of the eye cavity, and we're pulling our cord all the way through. Now, we hook that end of that cord over the top, and we twist. Now, once we've done 7 or 8 twists, we come back in underneath, and we twist around again, and we go back through. Now, a lot of guys will like to keep twisting that up until the hook's hard on the head, but I've found that the hook can't roll as well. I like to have the hook about that far in front of the bait. However, that presents a problem. A marlin can come along and whack that, and it gets his bill stuck in between with the bait hanging off the back. It also means that that hook can roll and turn back into the bait. Not ideal. So I got to thinking, well, I've got a really good hookup rate on my dead baits, whether they be a skip bait or a pitch bait, where I use a piece of solid tube to hold that hook out in front nice and tight. But of course, with a live bait, you can't get a bit of tube on there. So by adding this bit of wire right at the end of the rig for my last set of twists, I just pull the copper wire down alongside this ribbing twine and I twist everything together. Now you can see there, that copper wire is binding up around that thread. And by twisting it back up the other way till it's all the way back up to the hook, what that leaves me is a live bait, but now that's stiff. You'll see that there's no way that hook, just like a bit of tube, can push its way back. So I've got a nice stiff rig which can't roll back into the bait. You see there, it's holding out rigid, so it can't roll back into the bait. It's out in front, so I can still roll. And that there is my preferred live bait rig. A little bit more involved than using the rubber band rig, but the hookup rate thus far, and I've not been using it long, has been phenomenal. I'm on about 10 from 12 bites, and that's slow trolling as well as pitch baiting. So there you go, the copper wire pitch bait rig, and you can also take a look at this one in detail, step by step, with our watch and tie view.